Hello. Today we are going to talk about Section 138 of Negotiable Instrument Act, which talks about dishonor of cheque due to insufficiency of funds, etc. In our day-to-day life, every individual at some point of their life has to issue cheque on some or the other person's name. And if in that case, if the cheque presented is dishonored, which means if the bank returns the cheque, then under this act, it is a criminal offence against the person who has issued the cheque. Through this short video, I would like to convey what law is prevailing in India under Section 138 Negotiable Instrument Act and what is said under this section, which must be known to every common man. The object of the Negotiable Instrument Act is to encourage the usage of the cheque and enhancing the credibility of the instrument so that the normal business transactions and the settlement of the liabilities could be ensured. Now, when is a cheque dishonored? A cheque is dishonored when there is insufficiency of the funds in the bank account of the person who has issued the cheque, or when the person who has issued the cheque has instructed his bank for issuance of stock payment, or when the amount of the cheque exceeds the withdrawal amount of the bank, or when the signatures are mismatching. When the cheque is dishonored due to any of these said reasons, then the bank returns the cheque and the return memo stating the reason for the return of the cheque. This cheque and the return memo has to be kept safe. Now, once when the cheque is dishonored, a legal notice have to be sent to the person who has issued the cheque within 30 days from the receipt of the return memo from the bank, informing that the cheque is dishonored and demanding payment within 15 days from the receipt of the legal notice. Once these 15 days are over, cause of action arises. Now, once when the cause of action arises, a criminal complaint can be filed against the person who has issued the cheque within 30 days from the expiry of the prescribed time period. I hope this video regarding Section 138 of Negotiable Instrument Act would have been useful for you. And we look forward for creating more and more legal awareness through these short videos. Thank you.